Well, I think the adaptation process here, maybe not so much the language, because I was lucky enough to come with my family, you know, they received me, they kind of had that tolerance with me, but you know, getting used to the new things, starting with the culture. I remember one of the things that right away I came in April, it was April 1995, and then I saw it was sunny like today, so I just went out with a t-shirt, and it was freezing, it was so cold, it's amazing. So that was like a shock for me, because I was used in Venezuela, every time there's sunny and blue sky, it's really warm. So here, you know, I knew like the seasons were something quite different for me, and then the whole Canadian culture, no? But I had the fortune of being with my family. They really guided me a lot. And then I had the opportunity to go and know Vancouver little by little, start working and start developing here little by little. The reason why I left was basically, you know, the situation that wasn't improving on the country was getting worse and worse. And then at that time, my mom was still alive. And then we had family here for many years that came directly from Italy right after the war at the same time that my mother went to Venezuela. So they were planning like to bring both of us here because the situation, the condition here was a little bit better than in Venezuela, especially like the two main things were healthcare, which is very, you know, it's very poor in the public sector and extremely expensive in the private sector, and also the insecurity, you know, a lot of crime, especially in Caracas, where I come from. Oh yeah, I like it very much. It's been almost 20 years, and I've been, now that I have had the opportunity to see, you know, and compare it with the rest of the world, it's one of the really the nicest places on earth, and I feel that everyone here is very lucky, you know, because sometimes, especially when we come from places that are quite different, then we can kind of compare and see, wow, how lucky we are here with the safety, with the things that we have, with the weather when it's nice. Well, I think that unfortunately the difference is that it has gotten worse and worse. The main problem, as I mentioned, you know, at that time that made me and my family come here were, you know, the problem with the healthcare and the insecurity. And as far as I know, because I still have friends there that I grew up with, that has like getting so worse and so much troubles now, especially right now there are all kinds of trouble in the country. So I think it has been, you know, a process of continuous deterioration in the country since that time until now. And it seems that it's going to be very hard not to get out of that, according to what I read in the news and to what my friends tell me from Venezuela. Yeah, actually, both of my parents were Italian, but right after the war, they both went to Venezuela and I was born there. No? At that time, a lot of immigrants from Italy, no, right after the war, they went to Venezuela. There was a sizable, very big Italian community in Venezuela. And I grew up actually knowing both, no? Having the Venezuelan culture and the Italian culture at home. And that's the reason why, as you mentioned, I'm kind of half and half. No? Of course, I'm from Venezuela. Spanish is my native language, but I'm also very close to the Italian culture. And then when I came here, since all my uncles and aunts are from Italy, that part also got kind of stronger. And all my cousins here are both, you know, they are born here in Canada and they also speak Italian. So it's kind of a nice mix of culture, no? That I feel lucky that I know Spanish, Italian, and now the Canadian culture too. Yeah, Style Brands actually is the kind of the second business of my family, the one who sponsored me. It's actually a wine agency, or now, because it used to be Style Wines, we were specialized just in importing and distributing wines here in BC through the BC Liquor Board. Now we changed it to Style Brands because besides wine, we also bring beer, whiskey, or other kinds of spirits. And it used to be mainly from Italy because my uncle used to do it as a hobby. He started only with one product, and now we have over 400 products in the market. And it's a very, very controlled market that it's very hard not to get in, but the margins are not the same as any other retail business. And there is, of course, a lot of competition of other agents and, you know, getting people's preferences and all that. But it's an exciting business because all the time we are bringing new products, we are doing these tastings, and people really like it, enjoy it. And that's the part that I work, since I studied business administration in Venezuela, so I do pretty much all the paperwork in the main office regarding Canada Customs and the BC Liquor Board. Well, I think the best method is the one that I had, at least it's called the bilingual method, since I learned English in Venezuela as an adult, so it was all grammar-based and based in your first language, no? Since I already was an adult and I knew Spanish, so the very first few levels, they were totally bilingual, so that helped me to go through those levels quite fast. And once we were at an intermediate level, they were kind of taking away the Spanish and putting more English. So I definitely believe that the bilingual method, especially at the beginning, is really good because it gives you the base to go to the base, you know, they explain the language in your own language. In this case, they explain to me how English works all in Spanish, so I could see the differences right away. In that process, I also relearned Spanish, and that's the way that you actually kind of pay attention to the way the language works, and then you can actually, you know, learn it properly. I always tell people, you have to learn both, you know, vocabulary, of course, because we need it to communicate, but especially the grammar, because the grammar is like the structure of the building, and then you just put the vocabulary there and you create your own sentences. No? It's quite different from just learning phrases, that this phrase means this. No, it's better to know the structure, why things are said the way they are said, and then that way you can create your own sentences. Well, the goals will be, you know, to keep, of course, living here, growing in all the areas that I'm doing right now, growing with Style Brands, growing my tutoring company, both in the ESL, since I think I offer one of the few courses here, I call it ESL for Spanish speakers, because again, I use the bilingual method that I learned in Venezuela to explain it to people in Spanish. Learn that part, also I teach Spanish to Canadian and English speakers, so grow that part too, and also help my wife, Elsa, that she's also working here as a counselor after, you know, getting her credential recognized, something that took 5 years. So I do all the administrative part of her private practice. Well, first, to be kind of thankful that you made it here. I know that it's very, very hard too, because we all come from different backgrounds and for different situations and reasons. I had the opportunity to be an ESL volunteer teacher for Mosaic, so I had the opportunity to meet immigrants from all over the world, and I could see that like firsthand. And then, you know, to try to work hard to try to go through that first stage. You know, they call it also the honeymoon stage, when everything is nice, but then there is that part that is kind of the depression, where actually reality hits you. That's the part when you really have to keep strong, remember like why you came here, and then try to see all the nice things here. No, it's not easy. It's not easy for anyone. You really have to work hard. But at least if you do, there is stability in this country. There is so many good things that you can actually take advantage of being here. No? So the main advice will be, once you are here, try to stay here and try to work hard.